Hey guys, this is Siddharth and this is going to be a review of JioFi 3 4G personal Wi-Fi hotspot router device thing. So this basically is a wireless data router available for around 2000 rupees, which uses a Realiance Jio SIM to provide a Wi-Fi hotspot and can also be connected to a PC via USB to provide internet. The device is locked to only use a Jio SIM but may get an unlock method in future to make it work with any SIM. So in the box, you get the JioFi device, then you have some manuals telling you to install Jio 4G voice app, some setup instructions and the warranty card. You of course get a charger and a USB cable too. This is a feature overview which tells you about the internet hotspot you can create with this device to connect up to 31 devices while also sharing micro SD card contents with them. So this is the device. It has a status indicator LED on its front, a micro USB port on its left and the power and the WPS button on its right, which you can use to connect this device to a smartphone without having to enter the password. You get a 2600 mAh battery which should last up to 7 to 8 hours with 2.5 hours of charge. After opening the device to insert the SIM, make sure you note the default password for the setup process. You have to lift this flap to access a nano SIM and a micro SD card slot. You can use the micro SD slot to make the contents of the card available on any device that is connected to this router, so it's very useful for phones with limited storage. So after putting the SIM card and the battery in, you can hold the power button for around 4 seconds to power this up. The battery level is indicated by the battery light from blinking red to solid green when fully charged. The network strength is also indicated with red, blue and green color on the LED at the center. And the Wi-Fi status LED is blue when the Wi-Fi is on and turns green when a device is connected. So to set this up, you have to first connect it to a device like a laptop or a phone. Then you have to enter the default password after clicking its name, known as its SSID. Then after you are successfully connected, you can open a browser like Chrome and enter jiofi.local.html in the address bar. You may get a prompt like this if you are using Chrome, so just click on it. This is the page showing all the information about this device, but you have to log in by clicking on the top right button and entering administrator as both the user ID and password. You can also change it just after logging in if you wish to by clicking OK on the next prompt, but you can also choose to configure this later. So after being successfully logged in, you can see that you have a very easy to navigate UI for configuring everything. The status page gives you all the information about the device, but you have to go to the network management tab and click on Wi-Fi configuration on the left pane, and then you can change the network name, its security type and the password. You can use the other tabs to configure Wi-Fi disk for the microSD card and to manage the users, which also includes changing the login password in case you didn't choose changing it earlier. Now let's do a speed test. The speed can vary a lot depending on what time you test it at. I got around 8 Mbps at around 7 PM, but the speed may go up to 60 Mbps depending on various factors like your time and your location. Now let's test if it can play a 4K video, and it was able to buffer the first part of video which didn't use much bandwidth, but it couldn't play it smoothly after the scene got more intense. But it may be able to play 4K videos when you are getting a good speed, like something above 20 Mbps. So that is it for the review of this JioFi 3 wireless data router. I hope you enjoyed watching it. So make sure you like the video if it helped you and subscribe to my channel if you like the content, and I'll see you in the next one.